How do you bond new concrete to old concrete? And this is very important. If you do this wrong, the patch is almost certainly going to fail and it's going to delaminate. So what you need to do in order to bond new concrete to old concrete, first, you need to clean the old concrete very well. There can't be any dirt, debris, oil, grit, anything like that that's going to prevent the new layer from bonding with the old layer. So the most common ways that you could do something like that would be maybe to scrub it with TSP or something like that, or maybe even a pressure washer. But in the world of concrete workers, what that means is acid wash. Acid wash is the most reliable way to strip away dirt, oil, debris, loose Portland that's ready to fail, and expose a substrate that's suitable to achieve a strong mechanical bond with a new layer of concrete. So to give you an example, you might mix muriatic acid and water together at the ratio of 7 parts water to 1 part muriatic acid, such that when you pour it from a plastic sprinkling can onto the area you're trying to clean, it does foam and hiss a small amount, but not overly so. And then you would rinse it down and neutralize the area before you're ready to apply your new concrete over top of that. But wait, you're not ready to apply the new concrete yet. There's a couple of things you need to know about how to bond new concrete to old concrete. First of all, when you put the concretes all on, whenever you do whatever you're about to do, that old concrete needs to be wet. It can't be dry. That is the number one thing that you're doing wrong. If you're trying to get new concrete to bond to old concrete, it has to be damp. It can't be soaking wet. You can't have pooling water. That's not ideal, but it can't be bone dry either. And you have to be somewhere in that middle ground, damp, such that the water will permeate easily into the old concrete, because that's how you achieve the mechanical bond when you add new concrete to old concrete. So is that it? Just clean it up really good and make sure it's damp and go ahead? Well, actually, in theory, if you did that, you're probably better than most, and you're probably getting a reasonably good mechanical bond, but you're not getting as good as you could get if you used a slurry. A bonding slurry is something that you can make yourself, and it will allow you to achieve a better mechanical bond between new concrete and old concrete. And it's very simple how to make a bonding slurry, and it's something that's very forgiving to make. So what you would want to do is, normally concrete, you would use Portland and water, and then you would use some rocks and some sand and all this stuff. So it's kind of the same thing. You're going to use Portland and you're going to use water, but that's it. You don't use any sand, you don't use any gravel, nothing like that. But in addition to the Portland and in addition to the water, you're going to add a product called Weld Bond. Now, Weld Bond is the proprietary name of this product, and maybe that's not available in your area. What you can substitute, if you can't find the product Weld Bond, is just white glue. Regular old white glue, whether it's from crafting or whether you got some from the carpentry section of your local Home Depot, that kind of thing. Basically, you just want to add Portland powder, water, and a big dollop of this white glue together, and mix that all together until it's kind of a thick paste, similar to like warm butter, that kind of thing. And then you would just take a brush, like a big paint brush kind of thing, paint it onto old, clean, damp concrete, and then you apply your new concrete over that. And if you do those steps, where you acid wash and clean the old concrete, and then you make sure it's damp, and then you make a bonding slurry with Portland, water, and glue, paste that on to the old concrete, then apply your new concrete over that. That is the best way to bond new concrete to old concrete. And to give you an idea, you can achieve approximately an 80% mechanical bond in strength versus what would be a uniformly poured concrete. If you found this information helpful, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And you can check out my website, swimmingpoolsteve.com.